What's going on, guys? It's your average consumer, and it is finally time to talk about the Samsung Galaxy Note 9. And I don't know about you guys, but I'm really excited for this phone. But before we get into everything, you guys know I'm going to be giving one of these away. I'm actually teaming up with my boy John over at TLD today. We're going to be teaming up to give away one of these to you guys. And all you've got to do is make sure you're subscribed to the both of us and hit the link down below in the description to enter. But on to that Note 9. And obviously, we've got to start off with the design, and things are pretty similar here, but this year, we are only seeing two color variants coming to the US, and that's lavender purple and ocean blue. But what's pretty cool is that the ocean blue version has a contrasting S Pen that comes in yellow, and the lavender has a standard lavender S Pen. But more on the S Pen later. It has a beautiful 6.4-inch Super AMOLED Infinity display, and yes, the display is bigger by 1/10 of an inch, but I'll take it. This time around, right above and below that display, we've got stereo speakers tuned by AKG. Samsung's been coming out with some pretty decent stereo speakers on the latest Galaxy phones, but we've got to put it through the test in the real day in the life coming up soon. Now, all of that is great, but somewhat standard. So let's talk about what was a real highlight to me, and that's the storage capacity. And there's gonna be two configurations, a 128GB model, which is double from last year, and also a 512GB model, which is absolutely insane. And you also have the option with expandable storage to add another 512 to get a full terabyte of storage right on your device. That is gonna be awesome. I'm gonna be able to offload a ton of content so I can watch whenever I'm on a plane or traveling. This is gonna be nice. And these different configurations are something you're gonna wanna pay attention to considering all the things that the Note 9 can do. So let's talk a little bit about that and its performance. Now the Note 9 of course has a Snapdragon 845 processor, but what's different this time around is the thermal spreader, which is now 3 times larger than it was on the Galaxy Note 8, which means you're gonna get better cooling performance so that you can really push the processor to get the most out of it when using demanding apps. So I'm personally really excited to try this out, and when I get my hands on it, I'm going to be pushing it to its limits, throwing everything that I can at it in the real day in the life. And if you guys wanna see me use any specific demanding apps, definitely leave a comment down below with this name so I can go and try it out. Now, what makes all of that power and cooling performance even more impressive is when you start thinking about it with the Samsung DeX. DeX is a small device that pretty much turns your Galaxy device into a desktop. When connected to a display, you can play games, edit photos, web browse, all while using your phone as a trackpad and keyboard. Now, I'm not sure if the idea of DeX ever really took off considering you needed the dock and the keyboard and you just needed to plug a bunch of things in, but now it comes in the form of this little adapter that only costs 50 bucks and should be available as of today. So I'm really interested in seeing if this concept takes off. But what I really like is the fact that you're able to use your phone as a separate device even when it's connected to a display. So you can pretty much have whatever you want on that big display, even connect the Bluetooth keyboard and mouse to it so that you can just use it separately. And then you can access your phone and scroll IG or maybe even use your S Pen to take down some notes. And speaking of S Pen, this thing has become way more functional and interesting. Now in the past, the S Pen's been a convenient and tucked away stylus that you can pull out whenever you want to jot down notes or even navigate your phone. Now I used it a little here and there in the past, but it wasn't something that I always reached for unless I was looking to sign some documents. But now I feel like Samsung's given the S Pen even more of a purpose. And it now uses low energy Bluetooth, so you can use this thing as a remote. So if you've got your Note 9 hooked up to a DeX system and you've got a PowerPoint presentation up, boom, that's your clicker. If you're taking a group selfie, boom, that's your remote. Listening to music, control it with your pen. And you can do all that kind of stuff right with a single button on the S Pen. And depending on the app you're in, the button can be pressed in certain ways to access different things. So when you're in the camera app, you can double press to toggle between the two cameras and press it to take a photo. Apparently, Samsung's gonna be providing the SDK for this so that different developers out there can go ahead and implement the S Pen into their applications and have it do different things within that app. I'm curious about what you guys think. Are any of these new features coming to the S Pen enticing? Does that make you want the S Pen, or do you still not care? And speaking of developers, for all you Fortnite fans out there, it is finally coming to Android. The beta is now launching right with the Galaxy Note 9. So all of those people who have been dying for Fortnite, it's finally coming, but it's coming to Galaxy users first. And if you pre-order the Galaxy Note 9, I believe you get an exclusive skin. If you've got a Galaxy device, this is probably really good news to you. And of course, you know we gotta talk about the camera. And with the Note 9, you'll get dual rear cameras with optical image stabilization in both lenses, one being a 12 megapixel wide angle lens and the other being a 12 megapixel telephoto lens. And on the front, we've got an 8 megapixel selfie cam. And we should also get that same great low light performance that we saw with the Galaxy S9, since the Note 9 also has that dual aperture lens, which allows you to switch between a 1.5 and 2.4 aperture to allow more light in low light settings. But what's new here for Samsung at least are AI features built into the camera. So now there's a scene optimizer where the camera will analyze the environment, identifying what's in the scene like a plant or food. So it should automatically adjust the settings to optimal saturation, white balance, all the kind of stuff that people want to mess around with to get a great picture. But of course, we're gonna have to put that thing through some tests to see how it actually performs, but it will be aiming to provide the best settings possible for the subject in the shot. And there's also gonna be this new feature called flaw detection, where the phone is gonna be able to tell if someone blinks or has red eye so that it can let you know to retake the shot. And last but not least, my favorite big new feature is a bigger battery. Samsung has finally stepped back up and put a 4,000 milliamp hour battery inside of the Note 8. And of course they did tons of testing. I think they have an 8-point testing system. They put it through a bunch of tests to make sure that it's cool this time. Fingers crossed, but this is very exciting for me. They've been playing it safe for a little bit and of course included smaller batteries, but all day battery life, that, you can't ask for more than that. That is something I was really looking forward to and it is finally here. And of course it can be fast charged when plugged in or even fast charged wirelessly. And needless to say guys, I am very excited for the Note 9. While it may not look very different on the outside, I think what's under the hood is really what makes it different. Power users are really going to like the updates here, but the jury's still out on that. We'll of course have to test it all first, but that about wraps it up for this video guys. Hopefully you enjoyed it. If you did, be the cool guy or girl that gives this video a thumbs up and definitely check the link down below in the description if you want a chance at winning a Galaxy Note 9 for yourself. But till the next video guys, it's your average consumer. Real day in the life coming up soon. Till next time, peace.